Good day, guys, and welcome to my hurricane forecast. Today, I'm going to be running the GFS and the ECMWF model to see what happens in the tropics as we get 5 days out. Now, before I start this forecast, I want to thank you guys for helping me to get to 100 subscribers in just 3 months. And before that, I said that I'm going to be doing my reaction videos. Those are coming very soon, but I would like to focus on the tropics for now, because it seems to be getting very active about when we get into almost mid to late August, and the GFS and the ECMWF model shows potentially a tropical depression or a tropical storm forming as we get 5 days out. So let's start running the GFS model run to see what happens. Now, if you notice, as we get about 24 hours out, which is going to be on August 3rd, a tropical wave comes off the coast of Africa and it moves just south of the Cape Verde Islands. And you can see it does have vorticity in it and the center of circulation, and it seems to be somewhere in that area. So the vorticity is pretty tight with this tropical wave that comes off the coast of Africa, which would more or less cause an intensification, because remember, when a tropical wave emerges off the coast of Africa, they usually tend to have vorticity in them, but this is one of the tropical waves that has more or less a more stronger vorticity than the other waves had. So previously we have been seeing this tropical wave emerge off the coast of Africa with vorticity in them, but they do not usually get highlighted by the National Hurricane Center, or they usually do not even develop. But this is one of the tropical waves that the majority of the models are showing develop as we get 5 days out. So I'm going to be running the GFS model, then I'm going to be moving on towards the ECMWF model to see what happens with this tropical wave that comes off the coast of Africa. Now, it comes to my notice that when we get about, let's just go 30 hours out then, 30 hours out, when we get 30 hours out, this tropical wave, the vorticity in this gets stronger as we get 30 hours out around August 3rd. So, with the strength in vorticity and the more moisture content with this tropical disturbance that would, and the warm water temperatures that would cause intensification. So, we're going to be looking at the moisture content with this tropical disturbance after we finish the vorticity on this tropical disturbance. Now, when we get 36 hours out, this quickly intensifies. And you can see at this point, I'm going to say that it's maybe a low-end tropical storm or maybe a strong tropical depression. So, why am I saying that? It's because the vorticity in this tropical disturbance gets very strong at this point, and you can see that it does seem to have a center of circulation as the velocity indicates. So with stronger vorticity in it, it would be stronger than we expect it to be. So maybe it could be a tropical depression or a tropical storm. Maybe it could just even be a normal tropical wave. But I'm trying to say that the majority of the models are showing this form in the next, potentially in the next 5 days or in the next 48 hours. Because remember, a lot could happen in the next 48 hours. So let's go out to see what happens with this tropical wave. So let's continue to resume the GFS model run. So if you notice, about when we get 42 hours out, nearly 48 hours out, the vorticity gets tighter, which means that there might potentially be intensification happening with this tropical disturbance or tropical storm, or maybe a low-end tropical depression. So with this happening right now, after this point, I would expect it to more or less weaken, because it's heading into very cooler water temperatures that's just north of the Cape Verde Islands, which means that it would get weaker after it moves out of those warm water temperatures. Because remember, with the warm water temperatures, it would more or less prevent, more or less make the storm develop stronger. But as it moves into cooler water temperatures, it will prevent further intensification of a tropical depression or a tropical storm. Therefore, it would develop only when it's just south of the Cape Verde Islands, and when it moves north of that area, then water temperatures gets more unfavorable for development. So, I'm going to look at the moisture content with this tropical disturbance, and I'm going to show you guys how strong the moisture content could be with it, and I'm going to show you guys the possibilities of a tropical depression or a tropical storm forming within the next 5 days or within the next 48 hours. Now, this is the moisture content in this tropical disturbance at this time. And as you can see, it's at 1008 millibar. And that could potentially be a tropical depression at this point. And you can see the moisture content does indicate that it does have some vorticity in it at this time. And it does have more of a tight center of circulation and vorticity. So you could see the moisture trying to come in and wrap into its center of circulation, which means that there might be a tropical depression at this point. So we're going to switch over to the ECMWF model to see what that has to say on this potential tropical depression or tropical storm forming within the next 48 hours or in the next 5 days. Now, the ECMWF model does not go out too far. The model run just got renewed, which means that it does not go too far. Now, this is just a 0 hour forecast time, and you can see here is this, maybe it is this at this point, because I see the GFS model shows this tropical wave moves up towards the north, then it comes up towards the north, then starts to develop, or maybe it's this tropical wave that is currently coming off the coast of Africa. So with all of this happening, I'm going to look at the warm water temperatures that this could potentially head in as we get into 1 week or 5 days out or 48 hours out. So as I said, the warm water temperatures only extend south of the Cape Verde Islands. Therefore, when it gets just north of this area, it would more or less start to weaken when it gets somewhat in this area. Because if it keeps just south of the Cape Verde Islands, then it would more or less develop stronger, and it would more or less have less dry air to deal with. So with all of this happening, then this could potentially become a tropical depression or a tropical storm if it forms. But remember, all of this could change, and maybe it could just be a tropical depression, or maybe it could just be a tropical wave. But I'm just showing you guys that there could potentially be a tropical depression or a storm forming within the next 5 days or in the next 48 hours. So guys, I'm going to give you guys an update, and I'm going to be releasing my reaction videos very soon, about in the night. So thank you guys for watching, and thank you for watching this forecast, and continue to view my videos. I noticed my videos have seen a very good increase in the views that they get. So once again, thank you for watching, and hope you stay safe out there.